Good evening, children. Continuing with yesterday's topic, embedded nucleophile. Yesterday we have seen KCN and AGCN as two reagents which behave as an embedded nucleophile. When we treat haloalkane with KCN, we get cyanide as a product, and we treat it with AGCN, we get isocyanide as a product. Now, next two nucleophiles are also embedded nucleophile, that is KNO2 and AgNO2. KNO2 is potassium nitrite, AgNO2 is silver nitrite. When we take KNO2 as a reagent, our haloalkane reacts with KNO2 to give you alkyl nitrite. That is, here also there are two sides of bonding. One is nitrogen and one is oxygen. When we use KNO2, oxygen behaves as a site of bonding, and oxygen bonds to R of haloalkane. So we get alkyl nitrite. But when we use AgNO2, silver nitrite, that time nitrogen acts as a bonding site. Nitrogen bonds with R of haloalkane. So when AgNO2 is reacted with RX, we get RNO2, that is nitroalkane, as a product. So in one case we are getting nitrite, in other case we are getting nitroalkane. So oxygen as well as nitrogen in NO2 can behave as embedded nucleophilic site. And based on which reagent is used, we get our product. So one example I have written. Here methyl bromide reacts with KNO2 to give you methyl nitrite. And here ethyl bromide reacts with AgNO2 to give you nitroethane. That completes almost 9 reagents. Coming to next. Reaction with silver acetate or silver alkanoate. R stands for any alkyl group. To differentiate between R of haloalkane and R of reagent, I am writing R dash in the reagent. We get R dash COO bonded to R of haloalkane, and my product is AGX. This particular class of compounds is ester. So we can prepare ethyl, we can prepare amines, we can prepare ester using haloalkanes. We can even prepare alcohol, and haloalkane too can be prepared from alcohol. So interconversion of different class of organic compound is possible. Example, C2H5C reacts with silver acetate. Now silver, and this is acetate group. Then Cl is being replaced by nucleophile. So we get CH3COO bonded to C2H5 plus AGC. Name of this particular compound is ethyl acetate. This behaves as a substituent group. Coming to next, now we'll see reaction of haloalkane with another reagent which is very important in organic chemistry, that is lithium aluminium hydride. Now lithium aluminium hydride, as we discussed last year, is organometallic compound. It is used as a reducing agent. Lithium aluminium hydride is a very good reducing agent. It is to be written on arrow.
Ito, yan. Tapi na. Ito pa si Bruto pa ako. Jam na. Shooting ko lang ka? Ha? Jam?
With lithium aluminum hydride, haloalkane converts to alkene because it is a very good reducing agent. So Br is being replaced by H. H is coming from the reagent lithium aluminum hydride. So the C2H5Br will convert to C2H6 ethane. Here we mention only the main product. We do not mention the byproduct. Our last reagent is R-M+. Now this M+ is any metal like sodium or potassium, and that metal is bonded to alkene group. This is also reagent which will convert haloalkane into alkene. So R-X+R-M+ will give you R bonded to R-+MX. M combines with this leaving group halogen, and we get higher alkane. Here we complete all the nucleophilic substitution reactions. Mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now nucleophilic substitution reactions follow two parts. One is SN1 and another is SN2. Now SN1 and SN2 mechanism, whether it will be followed or not, will depend on type of alkyl halides. If our alkyl halide is 3 degree alkyl halide, allyl halide or benzyl halide, they all will follow SN1 path. And if it is 1 degree haloalkane or 1 degree alkyl halide, it will follow SN2 path. Now as the name suggests, SN1 and SN2, the full form is substituted nucleophilic unimolecular reaction and substituted nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. The 1 and 2 represents whether the rate of reaction is proportional to only substrate, that is haloalkane, which is 3 degree haloalkane, or rate of reaction is proportional to substrate as well as nucleophile concentration. As you know from last year's knowledge, the square bracket means concentration. If rate of reaction depends on concentration of only substrate and not on concentration of nucleophile, then that mechanism is called unimolecular, that is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction. And if it depends on substrate as well as nucleophile, then it is called as bimolecular reaction. As already mentioned, 1 degree alkyl halide will follow SN2 path and 2 degree alkyl halide and 3 degree alkyl halide will follow SN1 path. Now another point to remember is SN1 mechanism takes place in 2 steps, whereas SN2 mechanism follows only 1 step. The type of product which we obtain, here we obtain 2 types of product. One with inversion of configuration and other with retention of conjugation. Both 50-50%. Whereas here we get 100% inversion of configuration. In product. Now what is inversion and what is retention? That I will be explaining when I am explaining the mechanism. These are the points to remember. What happens in nucleophilic substitution unimolecular? What happens in nucleophilic substitution bimolecular? As this is a single step reaction, I will be explaining this first. Students, if you remember, in 11th standard, we have learned about dash and waist structure. Now, dash and waist structure, once again, I would like to remind you, these are the four bonds of carbon. These two bonds are in same plane. This bond is going inside the plane of bond, and this bond is coming towards you, that is outside. This is tetrahedral carbon. And all four its valences are satisfied with 3 hydrogen and 1 halogen. So, this is 1 degree haloalkane. When 1 degree haloalkane is attacked by nucleophile, that is OH minus, from reagent like NaOH, aqueous, KOH, aqueous, etc. That time, the nucleophile cannot attack from the front. Why it cannot attack from the front is because halogen is partially negative and OH minus is also negative. So both negative group will repel each other. So front side attack of nucleophile is prevented in 1 degree haloalkane. So nucleophile attacks from the back side, and when nucleophile attacks from the back side, this unstable complex is formed. In this unstable complex, OH minus is partially bonded and bond with halogen is partially broken. So this bond with carbon and hydrogen comes in a trigonal planar format, trigonal planar geometry from tetrahedral. So OH minus is partially bonded from back and X minus is partially leaving. So both these bonds are partial. Since this is unstable complex, it readily converts to give you product in which halogen leaves completely as X minus, that is leaving group. So bond between carbon and halogen is broken completely and bond between carbon and OH is formed completely. Now formation of this bond again gives it a tetrahedral geometry. So these groups are then pushed other side. When they are pushed other side, they will appear like this. So its geometry is 100% inverted. It had position in space on left hand side, halogen was on right hand side. Now it has position in space on right hand side and OH, that is nucleophile, has bonded on left hand side. This is called as inversion of configuration. If we obtain OH in the same place as halogen, then it is called as retention of configuration. So here you have to take two things in mind. This has occurred in a single step. Because this is unstable, it is not considered as a different step. So in one step only we obtained our product. Second thing, front side attack of nucleophile is prevented. So it can attack only from back side. So what we obtained is 100% inversion of configuration. So revise this today and we will continue with SN1 mechanism tomorrow.